I don't remember not being comfortable in the water. I grew up on Long Island Sound, and once I was old enough to get to the water by myself, it was really hard to keep me out of it. I think I'm part fish. I'm Kathy Howard. I'm a marine science magnet high school teacher in Groton, Connecticut. We're focusing, particularly in the science area, on marine ocean science, as well as aquaculture. And that theme we use to tie together with Long Island Sound, which is our local estuary, just down the road from us. We have students that come from all different backgrounds. Some have very little experience with water at all. We actually opened our doors about 11 years ago. And so we just are doing our best to fulfill that original intent, which was bring students closer to the shore and utilize that environment as a classroom.
What we're going to be doing today is we're going to a smaller version of a river that flows into Long Island Sound.
So we're sampling the water and seeing what fish are here at the moment so that we can see how diverse it is and how healthy it is.
Class is pretty good, but it's like not compared to being out here because you actually get to interact with like the environment.
Anybody recognize what that is?
Oh, that's cute. Striped bass.
Long Island Sound has actually been an estuary with national significance for quite a while. It's a really important nursery grounds for migratory fish. It's not a very large estuary, but it has a lot of human population around it. This designation of the National Estuarine Reserve here in Connecticut provides a better way to let public education know that we need to incorporate this into our classrooms to make sure that science is being funded in order to maintain and continue monitoring.
This is a really great indicator.
Long Island Sound really got a lot of attention scientifically when it became obvious that there was a lot of harm being done. It's becoming a success story. Things are getting better to the point where aquaculture is coming back and becoming very strong, which just gives us more reason to keep going. The science that you do in the classroom needs to be connected to why it's important outside of the classroom. Project Oceanology is a nonprofit organization that actually was started by the local school systems who wanted to have access to Long Island Sound to use as part of their education. And it continues to this day. 50 years this year. Each boat can carry up to 50 students, two instructors. They're literally built to be movable classrooms.
This is a female with a round abdomen.
If you haven't ever touched one, these are great crabs to pick up.
Making those links is really only possible for them if they can touch the things and feel the things and see how they actually are connected.
It's awesome. Like, I go here every year. It always gives me happiness, like, seeing certain animals come up. Like, today, we just saw, like, a skate. We had one in our marine biology class, but I've never got to hold it. And I just got to hold it, and that just brought my day. It was amazing.
I think that we have a lot of students that are starting to recognize, hey, you can do this. You can make the change.
I kind of want to do like an animal rehabilitation for marine animals, like sea turtles and sea lions. That's like my thing. I love marine animals.
My goal for any student that I come in contact with would be to leave with a true understanding that the oceans and humans are connected, and there's no way to separate the two. To have a student who has never had that personal experience of touching a live fish try for the first time, eyes brighten up, their ideas start flowing. That's that lifelong learning piece, that science is being done so that what we learn in the lab can be processed and utilized out in the community and out in the world. It's awesome to see them wanting to explore and being excited to come back, even though if they got wet, they come back and they say they're bored, but I saw the excitement. I know better.